All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Bloodborne Redemption Run. We are in the middle of the Nightmare Frontier. I just ran through the really poisonous area with these very poison-resistant armor. And what we're now doing is we are heading down around these ways. I believe what happens is this is going to lead us... I knew it. I fucking knew it. Okay. I need to equip the frenzy-resistant armor, okay? Alright, it's all thanks to Amazon. Remember that, guys. Alright. So, I gotta cross the bridge, I guess. Looks like here... Wait a minute, what's this? I'm assuming this is how I... Oh, shit. Ah, shortcut! No way! Nice! I had no idea, but I just opened up a shortcut. That is fucking excellent. Now I can go right back here. Yes, there's what's his name too, Patches. Wow, that was excellent. I had no idea that was a shortcut. Alright, let me ask you guys this, we're on stream. Alright, people who know this game better than me. Do you think that I've done enough? Have I done most of the Nightmare Frontier stuff at this point? You know what I mean? Have I gotten most of the good items? Is there anything very critical or important that I missed out on that I should grab? Or am I good? Because if I'm good, I'll just go fight the amygdala. Most people are saying I've done about 80%. Maybe I missed one or two items. Okay. Some people are saying shoot Patches. But some people, now someone says you cannot shoot Patches. It's a joke. Though some people are saying you can. I think people are completely undecided on if you can actually do this or not.
And of course, right now, there's people in... People are in the stream chat lying.
Oh! People want to see how we're doing with sub count. We're still at 451, guys. Still at 451. Get you up on that leaderboard. Thank you, Quack. Actually, King Swaggins is now... Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. King Swaggins is tied for top tier. I can't believe no one's shoot above 50, but okay. I'll update it.
I need dollar. That's what I need.
And don't worry, so that's it. I've cleared Nightmare Frontier, right? I just gotta kill the amygdala and then I'm done. I'm gonna fight the boss. Relax. Super Wombat Man is going nuts. Fight the boss! Fight the boss! I'm going to fight the boss. Relax. Oh! You apparently can do this. Look. Nice! Where did he go? How the fuck do I get out of this mo- How do I get out of the zoom? Dude, how do I turn off the zoom? There we go. What the fuck was that? So I hit him. Where did he go? What? It's gonna happen anyway. Are you kidding me? Dude, it happens anyway. This is bullshit. That's bullshit. What an asshole. I hit him and it still fucking worked. He still knocked me down there anyway. Shut up. No fear. The amygdala, I'm a little nervous about. Because I never beat it legit. You guys remember my first run? I was so overleveled, I was able to just stand at its foot and wail on the fucking foot for like 10 minutes till it died. I don't actually know how to legitimately fight the amygdala. So this is going to be like the first time I'm actually fighting the boss for real. And I have no idea how this is going to go. Did I get it? I got it. Nice. Nice. So, to fight the amygdala for real, you need to strike its hands in different positions, And the chains were perfect, dude. Dude, seriously, my chain was absolutely perfect. It was hitting it in different directions. That was amazing, dude. That was pretty good. Alright, so shout out to Jack Spartan because he said, shit, I didn't actually know you get to fight one of them. Yes, you do. And Dr. Devin RX just subscribed to the channel. Thank you, Dr. Devin RX.
Golf clap. Golf clap.
That was pretty good. I had no idea how to fight him. And I never saw his real attack pattern. Because remember, the first time I ever played, I just had the saw blade. I just sawed at his foot for like 10 minutes until he finally died. Here, I was able to just whip the hands repeatedly with the chain, which is really good. That was pretty cool. I don't think I have enough to level again. Nope. Alright. So, I guess we're done. Now I need to do... I'm going to do the DLC, guys. I promised all of you. I said after Nightmare of Frontier, I would do Old Hunter's DLC, and I'm sticking to my word. However, I don't know how to get there.
Are you serious?
I think it's something about the Yharnam Cathedral Ward, but I'm not positive, so... What? Now Rosito says, I should fight the Kanehurst Hunter NPC before going to the DLC. You say that after I'm already there. By the way, yeah, that's right. I was supposed to go get Alfred, wasn't I? Oops. Maybe I should do that. The Hunter's Nightmare. Alright. I should go see Alfred first, guys. Sorry for the blue balls, but I am going to go see Alfred first. I'm just waiting for someone to tell me where to go, because I don't know where to go. Oh, nice. Find some blood vials. You was there, turn left when you go back. Okay. So it was here, but turn left. How do I get there? Oh shit, how do I get to the DLC? I don't know, how do I get to the DLC? How the hell do I get up there? Oh boy. Quite a lot of hits to kill that guy. I don't know about this, guys. I don't know if I'm leveled enough to do this. You saw how many hits it took to kill that fucking guy? Wow, I couldn't even move. Stupidity. I couldn't fucking move. All I wanted to do was turn around and hit, and instead he's just like fucking around, dude, flubbing around, rolling on the ground like an asshole, instead of just attacking. So fucking stupid. If I had known the dogs were coming, I would have had the chain out. Annoying. No, they didn't even bite hard. So it was, oh, the dogs bite hard as fuck. No, they didn't. It took 3 to 4 bites to kill me. The problem was the stupid fucking flubbing of the guy. Duh! I have 4 animations I have to do before I can fucking pull out my fucking staff and attack. I'm just trying to learn the timing on these guys. All I wanted to do was learn the parry timing right there. The fuck out of here.
What did you say, nigga?
Wow. That was what, 100% damage?
You got knocked the fuck out!
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that I probably should be higher level to do this DLC at this point. I'm just saying. Seems to me like it's pretty ridiculously overpowered compared to me and what my abilities are right now. The fact that I'm dying with one hit to some of these guys is pretty ridiculous. Yeah, this is stupid. It really is. It really is dumb. They have poise, which I don't have. They have poise, so they can just, even though they're supposed to be hunters equivalent to me, they can attack right through my attacks. I parry them, they ignore the parry, and they do insane damage. This is fucking dumb. This is not meant for my level. I can already tell this is not meant for my level. I'm supposed to go, probably come back when I'm like level 70 to 80. There's no way. They shouldn't be doing that much damage. That's ridiculously stupid. They ignore the gunshots. They fucking ignore the parry gunshot. That's so fucking stupid. Why are they ignoring it? They're like, I'm not even firing. Yes. Wow, that's really great. No, that's actually not. It's really bad. It's stupid.
Stupid.
You're really fucking dumb right now. I'll be honest, already I think this is stupid.
Stupid.
I don't think this is nothing like the rest of the game. A bunch of enemies you can't parry. Well, that's really fair. We all have amazing poise, and we can just continuously hit you for 50 to 60% damage attacks, and when you try to parry us, we ignore it. Wow, great fucking DLC. I'm gonna leave. I'm serious. At this point, there's no point. This is so dumb. There's no point in even doing this. This is so stupid. FJ Resto, he says, you recommended you're level 65 to play the DLC at least. I think I am 65. I think I'm just 65. Right? What level am I? She claims I'm 69, but then I should be not dying within 1 to 2 hits, and my attack should be effective, and they're not. This DLC is going to be terrible if I can't do any damage. Seriously, I should go do other shit. I should go do the further into the story, and then come back here later. What is the point? I'm just gonna keep dying. I can't even kill the first fucking enemy effectively without using a ton of items. This is so dumb. Keep in mind, this DLC was designed to be post-game. It was actually designed that you do this after you've beaten the game because it came out months later. Point in doing this. There's literally no point in doing this now. It's a waste of my time. I'm just gonna die 400 fucking times and not progress. And I'll get to the final bosses, I probably won't even do any damage to them. I don't know about this DLC, guys. I don't. I think it's going to be too ridiculously overpowered for me. This is the early game stuff. I've already used a ridiculous amount of items and shit. That thing is ugly! And it has the same range.
Really, nigga?
Aww. I don't even know what hit me. He hit me with the first axe, I dodged, and then I got hit by a second attack that he wasn't doing. There was some weird late hitbox. So I backstabbed him, visceral attacked him, hit him multiple times, he still didn't fucking die. Wow. Well, I'm just not fighting this guy. Fuck it. I'm seriously not gonna waste my time. Fucking stupid. Waste of time. Yes, let's just make ridiculously OP enemies for this DLC. I wail on them, I backstab them, I do every possible thing, they still don't fucking die. Done. Fuck it. Not fighting him. Stupid game. Seriously dumb. I hit him a million times. He doesn't fucking die. He's a normal enemy. Okay, fuck that. Waste my time. Oh boy, here we go. If I remember correctly, there's a lot of searching to do down here with these spider dudes. They're really tough, I remember. But there's some good items behind them, if I remember correctly. Oh yeah, fuck that. Look how little damage I did. Forget it. I told you that I'm not ready for this DLC. I know I'm not. There's no way I'm ready for this. Seriously. I'm not ready for this DLC. I just hit the guy for probably 1/20th damage. That's fucking ridiculous. There's no way that's supposed to be how much I'm hitting him for. That's insanity. And I'm gonna clear a river of these fucking things? No way. No fucking way. This is so stupid. There's no way I can search this area because these guys have way too much HP. Lame. Oh god. Wow! I did like no damage! Can't kill it. I'm just gonna run. I don't do any damage to anything. I can't even fight any enemies. I don't hurt them. Why am I playing this DLC? I can't hurt anything. I don't know why I'm doing this. People are trolling me. Because I can't hurt anything. I'm at a point I can't even hurt the little regular enemies in the street. And I can't hurt this fucking guy. Like, what the fuck do you want me to do? If I can't deal any damage, what a waste of my time this is. Why am I doing this? Why am I toxic? What do you mean, who's trolling me? I decided to play the DLC. People have been screaming at me for 3 straight days, ever since the DLC was able to be played to play. It's obviously a waste of my time right now. Overly sensitive. If I can't do any damage to the regular spider enemies in the street, and there's a required mini boss I need to kill, and I backstab him and visceral attack him and it does 10% damage, there's obviously a problem here.
Oh, really?
So why am I doing this now? I should be doing this later. I should go, you know, get much further in the story so I can either use better weapons or I can, you know, upgrade my weapons that I have, and then I should come back here. This is wasting my time right now. It really is. It's wasting my time. All right, I'm out of here. I'll come back later and do it later in the game when I actually should have done it, instead of listening to a bunch of screaming people who just want to see me die 1,000 fucking times. I'll come back later. It's seriously a waste of time. I'm just going to keep dying and dying and dying and not getting anywhere, so fuck it. What a waste. I knew it. I just had a feeling. That if I went there, that it was going to be a waste of my time. Because it's supposed to be post-game content, or at least end-game content, and I'm not at the end of the game yet. You know? Sure, maybe if you're the best Bloodborne player, or you're someone who plays Bloodborne all the time, and you mastered the game, and you want to truly challenge yourself with timed parries and everything, and you want to fight that mini-boss for 10 fucking minutes, whittling his health down hit by hit, then maybe you could do the DLC now. Sadly, guys, that's not me. It never was me. So... pretty unrealistic expectation that I'm going to do a post-game DLC before I'm in the post-game. Well, I got a trollish $12 tip that says, if I don't like this game, go play something else. Yes, because obviously, because I'm playing a DLC that I'm not ready for yet, because I'm too low level and don't have good enough equipment, I hate the game overall. Keep in mind, I've been enjoying the hell out of this run up until now when people demanded that I go to the DLC too early.
Right.
YOLO the opportunity, so you just need to upgrade your weapon. Yeah, but I told you I'm trying to get the Chikage. So if I'm trying to get the Chikage, I can't upgrade this weapon anymore because I'm going to waste too many crafting items. And by the way, as you can see playing the game, I don't need to upgrade the weapon anymore. I'm killing everything really easily in the normal game. King Swag is cheered and said, go beat Rom and Mikolash and then come back. It'll be more fun that way. That's what I'm going to do. That's exactly what I'm going to do. Right, Eternal Napalm just cheered. He said, people just wanted to see you struggle and laugh at you. You're doing great, keep it up. You're absolutely right. That's all it is.
Really, nigga?
People want to see me fucking struggle with obviously the hardest part of the game, the DLC, which everyone says. And they want to see me fail and fail and fail. They don't actually want to see me have a good time and enjoy a game and progressively get better at a game and learn. They just want to see me rage and fail because they're a bunch of negative fucking dickheads. And you know what? I'm tired of it. I really am at this point. Like, I just want to play a game and have fun like everyone else. I'm tired of people just coming by to make my life fucking miserable. So if that's the reason you're here, get the fuck out. Let's put it that way. I will go back and do the DLC when I'm ready for it at the end of the game when every other logical fucking human goes and does it. That's when I'll do it. So there you go. And some idiot actually just said, this is how you don't play. Even though I've been doing incredibly good today. But I suck. I'm a terrible gamer. I'm horrible. Alright, guys. So let's continue on with the main game, which is what the fuck I should have done to begin with. Bergenward. You would have thought doing this 10 years, I would have learned my lesson and realized that people are just trying to fucking troll me constantly. But I guess not. I'm just not smart enough to figure it out yet. Maybe one day I'll wise up, but not yet.
But I'm a retard.
There's nothing special about you.
Paradox Charity, so people like to rush Don't Listen Phil. Oh god, I forgot about this. Alright, I got a dollar tip from Hall & Oates. He says, not sure what level you are, but reading some suggestions online, people are saying if you're not even at level 80, don't even bother with the DLC yet. Thank you very much. I'm level 69, and by the way, I'm level 69, but I put far too many levels into skill, I think, for me to have a really good build. So I don't have enough health. I'm not dealing enough damage. The DLC is not for me yet. I'll do it later, when I should have done it to begin with, because I never was going to do it this early. My plan was to get near the end of the game and then go do it, which is what Ayers intended to do. But, you know, it is what it is, I guess. Johnnysaurus Rex just cheered and said, we still got your back, Phil. Well, thank you for that, Johnny. Hopefully now that I'm not going to be full of frustration and rage because of a bunch of immature people just wanting to see that, I'll actually enjoy myself and continue with a fun playthrough. So here we go. And by the way, shout out to Cryonic, who I actually saw in the stream chat. My bad that I was in a frustrated mood. I didn't say what's up earlier. Oh, I'm getting owned right here. Tolo's here too. What's up, Tolo? Tolo, it's hard for me to see your name because your name for some reason shows up in black text on my screen and I use dark mode. So all I see is black on black. I can't see anything. And then I saw your sub crown. I was like, wait a minute, is that Tolo? Oh yeah, it is. My bad. What's up, Tolo? He said that Cryotic had to grind to level 130 to beat the DLC. Is that true? I don't think I don't need to be that high level, but I can't do it right now, man. For me, see, I'm not the kind of person... Like, I know... Let me put it this way. All right. I could beat the DLC, but it wouldn't be fun. It would be grind, 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 just fucking dying, 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 going back, and that's not fun to me. That's gonna, like, drive me nuts, and that's not what I want. You know what I mean? I want to have fun like I've been having, so... It's so stupid. Look at it. It's supposed to be... Oh, hello. Basically, all these guys are supposed to be people who are researching the old ones. Aw, man. Get out of here. Oh, boy. Right up my asshole. I knew that was coming. I knew that shit was coming, too. Because he always gets me with that shit. Alright, you fucker. Come over here now. No, no, no. Where you going? No, come back. You want to fucking hit me with a fireball? And you want to fucking walk away? Oh my god, I actually can't hit it. Okay. Oh, let's see here. Yolo Dopper trolling, whatever. Coral got cheered. He said, Phil, you're at your best when you take your time to explore, provide lore, and add your own funk to the game just like anyone else normally would. I agree. Not when I'm trying to grind on a DLC that's obviously too hard for me right now. Banana Lisk, I'm not banning anyone. I'm playing a game, so asking me why someone was banned in stream chat is pretty much completely pointless, because I have no idea. I'm playing the game. I don't know what happened, okay?
Inch. Am I right, ladies?
I'm not banning anyone. I'm playing a game, so asking me why someone was banned in stream chat is pretty much completely pointless. Eternal Napalm just cheered. He said, Ebrietas, daughter of the cosmos, is tons of fun. Yeah, she was the hardest boss for me in the first game. She seriously was in the first game, in the first run. But now I think I'm much more equipped to take her on.
Wrong!
I'll give Ram a shot here. I'll give it a shot. Let's see. I really doubt, out of all the bosses that I've been one-shotting, I seriously doubt I'm going to one-shot Ram. I mean, he's a pain in the ass with all those little spiders. Not only do you have to kill all the little spiders, then you got to try to hit him while he's shooting a bunch of projectiles at you. He's a major pain in the dick. So I don't think I'm going to one-shot him, but I'll give it a shot. A lot of spiders already. Oh, fucking shit! I never even saw him fire. I didn't know he had fired, and it just went ba 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 ba. Ow! I never even saw him fire. I got fucked. I got completely fucked right there, dude. Ouch. Alright. Shout out to Turgid Banana, who said, I'm about to eat a big burger. Should I use American cheese, blue, or... Oh, I'm not reading the rest of that. You're disgusting. You're a disgusting human being. Oh my god! God damn it, dude. That's what I mean. Like, you never even know when that's coming down. Sometimes it just fucking boom. Like, dude, I had him. I was going to run away and keep dodging and then go back one more time. But, all right, let's do this. Let's go fight the imposter Yusefka. Should be this way. The hell? Or not? Why is the door locked? I thought that's what the door I opened earlier. What the hell? Why did the door close? This is bullshit. I opened the door. Now I can't do it. Huh? I already went through the Forbidden Woods, King's Wagons, and I already opened the shortcut door. The door closes every time you warp? Are you serious? So, what do I do then? I gotta go all the way back through that fucking thing? Are you serious? I hope not. I guess I gotta go back through here. Right? Ladder. Oh, fuck! No! Son of a bitch! God damn it. Of course. Of course, a comedy pratfall. Fucking of course I had to fall there. Son of a bitch. Fuck. That really stunk, alright? It stunk. Well, at least they were nice enough to put my souls here. Now, where's the ladder? I wonder, there's no advantage to leaving her alive, right? This is the real Yusefka, there's no advantage. Alright, shall we grant her mercy here? Mercy kill? I guess so. Did you see that? She had an item on her, but she glitched and fell through the floor. And now I can't get the item. Alright, can I do it with only 7 healing items? I doubt it. This guy's a pain in the ass, I remember. This guy's a major pain in the dick. He took me a long time to beat in my first run. It is a fair fight, though. It's a 100% fair fight. It's just a really challenging fight. up, so I need more healing items. I could definitely beat him if I had full healing, but I only have a few left. He's not actually super tough. He's just interesting because he's a fair fight. He has all your moves. So it's fair as long as you have healing, which I don't. So I don't know if I could beat him right now. It sucks. I need to grind for blood vials, but I can't get any right now. Like, there's nowhere to go to get any. All I can do is use these and buy them. I don't want to fucking buy blood vials. Fuck. I need to get blood vials. Johnny Source has beat him for us. Why is it unfair? Ivan Bonus is unfair. I don't think it's unfair. Why is it unfair? I mean, he has infinite ammo. And yeah, he can keep using the stupid quick bone or whatever, but it's not like he's ridiculous. Dude, this is way too much damage. Come on. Oh, what on earth? This gun is ridiculously OP. I mean, it's actually easy to dodge, but you gotta see it coming. Dude, that is so OP. It's insane. 50% damage for a random gunshot. Yeesh. And no, that's not counter damage. I didn't attack. I wasn't dodging or attacking. That's just regular damage. Yeesh. What? I parried him and you can't visceral him after a parry? Apparently you can. I parried him, I couldn't visceral. Dude, what is that? You can't, huh? Yeah, people are saying you can't. Wow, I didn't know that. So you cannot visceral attack him ever, huh? What do you mean I didn't parry him? He was stunned. He was in the stun animation. But then he moved out of it right away. People are saying that wasn't a parry, huh? Okay. Alright. Well, I got fucked there because I couldn't see. Well, it healed too. We didn't notice. The problem with the fight, I remember, the reason it takes so long to beat is because they heal. They keep healing. It's very annoying. Wow. Wow, they wouldn't let me hit him. Good until he decided to randomly use the gun to do insane damage. And I hit him with numbing mist too, so he couldn't even heal himself, but I got fucked there.
Instant replay, please.
Finish him!
Flawless victory. Fatality.
You got knocked the fuck out!
Yes, I got all 0 blood echoes back. Nice. Got him! Got him! Very nice. I think I'm supposed to run past this thing, but I don't remember which way is the right way, because we got this and there's the other way too, right? That sounds disgusting. What's the other way? They all fucking respawn. Where the fuck's the bell ringer? Well, that was complete bullshit. I was looking for the bell ringer, and I happened to wander into an area where an amygdala shoots a fucking laser down out of nowhere, and I was supposed to remember that. That is fucking annoying right there, dude. 20-some thousand blood echoes probably lost. Ugh. Whipped right through that shit. I don't know how I'm gonna get these back now. I really don't. I don't know how I'm gonna get them back. This area is fucking bullshit. That is some fucking bullshit. Oh, the other one fell. Okay. Well, that was a good jump. There's nothing here! Oh, come on! No! King Swagger says, with this weapon, I beat Ebrietas in like 20 seconds. Yeah, because you just stay behind her leg, right? You just keep wailing on her. The reason I couldn't beat Ebrietas very, very effectively in my first run is because I didn't have a good enough weapon. Oh. Oh! Dodging past him. For some reason, his attack radius goes all the way behind him, too. Whatever. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Bloodborne Redemption run. If you remember, I had just died, which was not very pleasant, and died here in the Upper Cathedral War. Well, let's continue on.
けど今回の構想を収めるのに一番体張ったのもあの人だ。なんとかならないんですか、伊達さん。 桐生さんの担当刑事でしょ。
誰が桐生担当だ。人聞きの悪い。
そもそも桐生さんだけ逮捕されるってのはどうなんです。現役バリバリの登場会幹部はお咎めなしって聞いてますけど。
親の顔も知らないこの俺が沖縄に児童養護施設朝顔を作って引き取った子供たち、この子たちが遥と過ごした時間に俺がどれだけ救われたかは言葉にさえできない。だが
沖縄の朝顔のことですね。
ああ、俺がこのまま沖縄に戻ったとして朝顔の子供たちは遥と静かに暮らせると。
Oh crap, my audio just died again. Now it's back. I think we're gonna have issues with audio again. Creepy music. Now my audio died again. Yep. Alright, let me fuck up my headphones. Pain in the ass. It works now. Nope. Oh my god, dude, I have no luck anymore. I don't know what's going on anymore with my audio of my fucking PS4. I really don't. Sometimes it works, sometimes it just refuses to work. It was fine the entire pre-stream. Then I blew boot Bloodborne and it stops working. Alright. What am I sipping on? Kickstart. Mountain Dew Kickstart. What a pain in my fucking ass. So now I have audio. Let's see if it fucking continues to work. Apologies again, guys. I wish there was something I could do to fix this. There's apparently nothing. My PS4 is just having so many fucking issues now. USB ports not working properly. And the audio not working properly. And there's no way to fix it. Alright, shout out to, I am not actually here, who did 100-bit cheer, said, since I was falling asleep on stream, apparently I have sleep apnea because distractor BS. Well, first of all, I wasn't falling asleep on stream.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my god, stop fucking lying.
You guys know what he's talking about. Yesterday, last night, I was playing Yakuza 6, and the intro was so fucking long, drawn out, and boring, alright? Like, it was over an hour of intro cutscenes before the game started, and half of it was recap of Yakuza 5. So I was trying to do it, and like, no lie, it was so boring, because it was like, oh, here's a character, talk to them to explain who they are. I was like nodding off, I was like, oh my god. First of all, that's not sleep apnea. That's called narcolepsy, when you just fall asleep on the spot, okay? I don't have narcolepsy, geniuses. It was just a moment where it was very fucking boring. And then, but when I finally got into the gameplay of Yakuza 6, by the way, I was fine. It was like, wow, I can actually play the game now. This is fun. But the problem was it was so fucking boring to start. Level Up Gamer just cheated, said, is there a chance we'll see DSP destroy his PS4 tonight if the audio messes up during the premiere? No, not really. I mean, I'm not going to destroy my PS4. I need it. You know, it sucks that it's not fucking working. I don't have any money to get a new one. But it is what it is, I guess. Well, that was great. I just love that he has reach that's way further than what actually it shows. Because you see how he's holding his scythe, where he only has a little bit. So technically, he should have very short range. But then when he actually goes like this, for some reason, the scythe extends in his hands and like doubles in reach. Doubles in fucking reach. So stupid.
Stupid!
Like most of the stupid enemy attack animations in this fucking game. They're also ridiculously unrealistic. Oh boy.
Hey.
I got hit. I hit through the fucking door. How ridiculous. Where's the other one now? He's behind the door, look. I can't hit him. Crap. Oh, that's definitely fucking fair. Admittedly, this is pretty fucking silly. Dude, I couldn't get away! Oh my god! This is ridiculous. This is absolutely fucking ridiculous. It really is. There's no way for me to kill him. Because he keeps stunning me, and there's no way to dodge in this corridor. It hits you no matter what. Die! What a fucking asshole. And what really sucks, I have no healing now. I have no healing left. It's such a pain in the fucking dick. Seriously. I'm talking blood at least as stun and run. Yeah, but you can't. You can't stun and run because there's no way to stun him. That's the problem. So Matt, oh, he's talking about him, I guess. Yeah, that's bullshit. He stuns, and then he runs the entirety of the fucking length of the screen and fucks you over. Like, what the fuck, man? That shit is cheap. Shout out to Level Up Gamer. He says, I was joking with the last cheer. I wish you the best of luck with your premiere of God of War, and I hope everything goes smoothly. I hope you see the fan art post on the King of Hate forums. I'll give it a look. All right, I'm trying to pay attention to a very difficult game, and we've got a jerk in the stream chat talking crap, and he is now permanently banned, so enjoy it. Moo the space cow. Banana Lisk, I'm not banning anyone. I'm playing a game, so asking me why someone was banned in the stream chat is pretty much completely pointless, because I have no idea. I'm playing the game. I don't know what happened, okay?
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my god. Stop fucking lying.
You can go moo somewhere on greener pastures outside of my stream because I'm trying to concentrate on a game that's very tough and you're being a dingus. So there you go. Like overly sensitive. Why am I toxic? What's funny is I don't see the guy. Where the hell is this guy who's the ambush? I seriously don't see him. Oh, there he is. That's his head. That's his head sticking out over there. I'm gonna just have to run by these guys. There's nothing else I can do. I just gotta run. All right.
Get the fuck over here!
What?
Omae wa mou shindeiru.
Nani?
What? Well... That's insanely ludicrous. That's insanely ludicrous. I was doing a full speed running jump and he sniped me in the middle of the jump. Get the fuck out of here, dude. That was bullshit. I'm sorry, I'm calling it. That was fucking bullshit. 100% bullshit. That was insanely ridiculous bullshit. Come the fuck on now. Give me a break. Seriously, give me a break. The sad part is now I have no vials. I have to go grind for vials and there's nothing I can do about it. Because I'm not gonna waste my fucking souls on it. Oh, oh. give us quicker from Yharnam. Where I'm in Yharnam. This is the cathedral ward of Yharnam. So what are you talking about? I'm going to buy vials with the non-existent blood echoes that I have. I'll buy vials. Thanks. Thanks for the recommendation. And another troll bites the dust. And another troll gone. And another troll gone. Another troll bites the dust. Hey, made your account today. Another troll bites the dust. Okay. Well, right back to where I was. The question is, how do I kill these fucks? Seriously, no, how do I kill them? Because the magic, I can't deflect the magic they use. So I'm not sure what to do to stop them from stunning me and sucking my brains. I don't know.
What could possibly go wrong?
You gotta be joking. Tell me what I'm supposed to do here. You know what I mean? Like, this is complete bullshit. So I fucking was invisible. I go for a backstab. The backstab doesn't work. Even though I'm invisible and behind the guy completely, the backstab doesn't work. So I don't get a visceral. Then I just can't get a combo. What the fuck do they expect from me? Seriously, what do they expect from me? What do you want me to do? It's just fucking stupid at this point.
Stupid.
That was fair. Look at that. Now explain that. Let's think about this for a second, okay? I hit him to the point where he was completely destroyed. He had no health left. I'm hitting. I'm still going. We trade and I die. And he dies too. There should be no trades in this fucking stupid game. There really shouldn't. Trading death is the fucking dumbest thing ever in the fucking video game. Trading death. Gangbang. I thought maybe I could try to speedrun it. I'll show you. I know for a fact because after I fought this boss the first time, I looked up some playthroughs online of people who were playing the game. And if you do enough damage to the guy, the one that's the real Celestial Emissary, fast enough, he'll never transform. But you need to deal like tons of damage to him. So that's what I was trying to do right there, and it didn't work out. I'm going to try again. He just runs away. See that? Well, that didn't work. I mean, I did a ton of damage to him, so that's good. I'm trying to dodge. What the fuck? Stupid camera fucked me over. I didn't want to lock on to anybody. Oh my god, he has tons of reach. That is so annoying. Arr. I had a chance and he had to do the fucking SWAT attack, so I can't hit him. Wow, good dodge. Hits me mid dodge for giant damage. Hell yes, from. Huh. Well, I guess you learned something. Again, remember my first run, I didn't really know about the lore or nothing. Bouncy, bouncy, motherfucker. Alright. Guess what time it is, guys? Time to take on Ebrietas. This is gonna be a pain in the dick, just like it was the first time. So, I remember how to do it. You gotta stay behind her. Remember there's the two like tentacle legs. You gotta try to stay behind one and just keep stabbing in the back. And then every once in a while, dodge. When she tries to spin, you gotta stay behind her and just keep wailing on her back area. The only difference is I think every once in a while she does that area of effect arcane attack, right? So, alright, we'll give it a shot. I don't know how long it's gonna take me. Last time it took me a million years to kill her, remember? Alright, ready? Oh, here we go. Let's do this. If I remember correctly, this only this first time when you fight her do you get a chance to get behind her. I get a free shot to get behind her right now because she's not awakened yet. After this, she's awake. Wow! Well, I did a shot, and she decided to back off and then headbutt me, which I don't think I've ever even seen that attack before. Actually, remember, the first run, I couldn't figure out where to go, because if you just stand in front of her, you get fucked. She has these big sweeping arms that make it almost impossible to hit her. So you gotta stay at that angle to stay at her like right tentacle and keep stabbing her in the ass. So I was doing it right, but then all of a sudden, she decided to back off and do a headbutt. Oh, you can't. You can't use it on Blades of Mercy, huh? Apparently, you can't use it on Blades of Mercy. Why not? Oh, Ptolemaeus is a great weapon. Yeah, great weapon. You can't even use bolt paper on it. Oh, I have no stamina. Oops. Oh my god, I'm dead. Hitbox there. Apparently there's a hitbox when she moves. I didn't even know that either. Because I took damage even though she didn't even swing. Huh. Okay. See, I don't really know how to use these Blades of Mercy very well. I've only had them for, like, what? Just one area, that was it. So I don't really know what I'm doing. After I took a ridiculous amount of damage, I didn't want to waste my blood vials. I figured it's just better to do another run and try not to die. Huh? That was a mess. I didn't heal because there was no point, because you had already done ridiculous damage. The whole way to win this fight, you stay at one of the tail legs, you keep slashing from the side, and when she hits you, you gotta get your health back right away by continuously slashing. That's the way you win the fight. You know, every once in a while, if you get bad luck, you get a giant chunk taken out, then you heal, but I didn't want to waste my vials. The thing is, you guys are all, you think I care about, like, death count. I don't. I don't care about dying repeatedly to this boss.
Oh, really?
Aw, man, I couldn't see. Yeah, that's lame. That's lame because I couldn't see where she was attacking from, so I couldn't dodge. And the next thing you know, I'm stuck on the side of the map. Once again, the bad luck. I actually was doing it perfect, and then all of a sudden she decides, I'm going to do a move where you can't see because the camera went into her fucking face. And then I can't dodge, and the next thing you know, I'm stuck on the wall. Well, Turgid Banana Sheared 100 Bits said something gross I'm not going to repeat. And Chairman Caleb said, don't feel bad about the boss that was stuck on her for hours. No, dude, don't you remember my first run? Literally, it was like 3 hours for me to beat her. It took a long time for me to figure out the pattern. Eternal Napalm just cheered, said, Ebrietas, daughter of the cosmos, is tons of fun. Yeah, she was the hardest boss for me in the first game. She seriously was in the first game, in the first run. But now I think I'm much more equipped to take her on. Rausito says, I never died more than twice to Ebrietas. Well, Rausito, that's because you have an insanely large E-penis. Didn't you know that? Like, it's at least several hundred ASCII code characters to make up your E-penis. So, that's why we can't all be like you. We have to die repeatedly to Ebrietas. What else can I say? I was in the sweet spot, yet she was still hitting me somehow. I don't know. That's the sweet spot, and somehow she's still hitting me, so whatever. I was trying to run and dodge. Stuck in her hand now. Yeah. She has that weird, see? A weird tentacle, sometimes it pushes you out of the way. She has this weird tentacle that pushes you out of the way. Sometimes when she goes into that neutral stance, her hand will clip you, which is stupid. Her hand clips you out of where you're standing and knocks you out of where you're positioned, and then she can hit you. I wonder why they won't let you use bullet paper in this fight. Because I'd be doing double damage. I don't know why they won't let me. Massive damage. Why? It's not even a hit. It's not even an attack animation. She has an animation that just randomly hurts you. It's not an attack. What the fuck? Nothing I could do. She just decided to turn, double turn, which normally she doesn't do. She decided to turn twice quickly and then just start hitting me. So I couldn't get out of the way. Come on, bullshit. Dude, her head's right in front of me. And I'm attacking and nothing happens. Fucking stupid. She's headbutting and her head can hit me. But then when I try to hit the head that's literally directly in front of me, whiff, 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 whiff. Come on. Stupid hitboxes. Well, I'll keep trying, but if it keeps being this difficult, I might just, like I said, go back to the fucking cane and use bolt paper so I can do double damage. Sadly, the cane's the only other thing I can use. It's the only other weapon I've had in this playthrough. You know, I don't have any other weapons that are going to deal any significant damage, so... Oh, yeah, that's right. What? There's nothing there. Bullshit. Yes, because I'm in the good place to keep attacking her. She decides now I'm going to lift for an animation that shouldn't have a hitbox. Let's create an animation that's just a movement animation where she hits you for no reason. I hate that. What? Wow, I got robbed. What? Nothing hit me! nothing hit me. Absolutely nothing hit me. There was no attack animation. Her attack animation was the swipe, and it did that much damage. Then all of a sudden, my whole energy bar disappeared. Nothing hit me. And no, I didn't get too greedy. I wasn't even attacking. I was just waiting. That was complete bullshit. Well, now I can't kill her. Now I need more health. Yeah, I got double hit by a bullshit hitbox. You're right. The hitbox hit twice for one attack animation. It's garbage. Complete bullshit. Yeah, because remember, she has that area of effect attack. That it's doing damage over time to me. So at the end of the fight, I just got to keep rationing my healing. But it's complete horseshit that all of a sudden a double hitbox hits me. What? Here's the attack. Hits me twice. Okay, From Software. Yep. Anyway, as you can see, once you stay there, it's not hard. That's what you guys get for making fun of me for 10 straight years saying I'm bad at games. Now it's all coming back. Comes back to bite you right in the butt. Alright, so stupid. It really is stupid. I'm sorry. I hated the fight the first time too. Because it is. There's a stupid wonkiness to that fight. Oh, it's going to hit twice now. One attack hits twice. Okay. Like, it's not hard enough she's doing area of effect damage. Now you're going to do double damage to me. The fuck out of here. Eternal Napalm, I can't do what you're suggesting. He's suggesting stay in front of her. And when she comes for you, dodge her attacks and then counterattack with a charge attack. Can't do it. I don't have the weapons to do what you're suggesting. In order to do that, I would need big range weapons that deal at least good damage, and I don't have them. So I can't do that. Your strategy would only... No, boy, Eternal Napalm, you're not listening to me. He says, but if you're in front of Ebrietas, you could get easy visceral attacks. No, you can't. Not with the weapons I have. Both weapons I have are short range weapons. You can't... The only weapon that I have that's long range is the whip, which you can't do viscerals with. So I can't do what you're suggesting. Yes, if I had used a weapon that had good range, I could have done the method that you're suggesting. The way that I have with the loot set, the loadout that I have to use the weak spot to beat her. Because I have to be close to her to hit her. Yeah, people are saying, well, if you use the cane, even though it sucks, you could at least apply bolt paper to it. And I mean, that is a good point. No, Jubaka, I'm not very excited for the Dark Souls remaster because I just played the game. I just played it a year ago. It would have been one thing if I hadn't replayed Dark Souls last year. But I just replayed it, so I'm not really hyped for the remaster because I just played the game last year. Let's see. Will it hit as effectively as the blades? Shout out to Noko for days! Who just resubbed for the 16th month in a row and said, keep it up, Phil. Oh, I'm gonna beat her. I mean, I beat her the first fucking time. I'm not gonna give up. I'm definitely gonna beat her. Oh, two hits? Come on. Now I'm getting robbed. Highway robbery. Yeah, dude, what the hell? 100% bullshit. 100% cheating. That was horseshit. The king was doing okay damage. I think if I put the bull paper on it, it'll do really good. But that was complete bullshit. Come on, man. Yeah, now she's going to use every attack that's going to hit me on that side. Get the fuck out of here. Lame. What's hilarious is people are complaining just like they did in my first run. Why isn't Phil healing? Why is it... Because I'm just fucking practicing. I'm trying to learn how to do this with the cane and or find the effective thing before I waste all my fucking blood and then have to go farm it again. That's why. I don't want to waste my time. I swear to God, people have been so brainwashed into thinking that every time someone plays a Souls game or a From Software game, it has to be like a perfection challenge run where you don't practice and instead you beat on like the first shot. What the fuck? What? Yeah, what is going on? Dude, she was not doing this before at all. Well, I went for a visceral. Missed. Bad luck. The cane's the better option. I hate to say it, the cane is the better option here. It actually is. As good as the Blades of Mercy are, the cane's actually fucking better. It's doing just as much damage, and if I put bull paper on it, it's gonna do double damage. So I'm gonna go with the cane. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the cane, for sure. It's better than Blades of Mercy in this situation. Which is sad, because I was, you know, the only reason I really got the Blades of Mercy is because I thought it was gonna, like, demolish stuff, but I guess not. That's right, I should be using the tiny music box. Why aren't I using the music box in this fight? It completely stuns her, right? She doesn't attack at all. What the hell was that? Dude, that was wonky as hell. Okay. I was doing fine until she decides to do that one attack that normally she doesn't do. Yeah, right. Booty call me says 10,000 bits if I beat the boss on this try. 10,000 bits I'll never see. Alright, well. Since we got a little bit at stake here, let's use the bolt paper. In fact, hold on. It's gonna run out. I already fucked up, but it's alright. I got 10 of them. Rude. try. Yeah, I was so fucking loud. It's so stupid. Why are the sound effects so fucking loud? I was screwed from the start because she went to the corner. As soon as she went to the corner, that was it. Because I couldn't get solidly around her. So I knew I wasn't going to win. Because I kept getting caught on that coffin, which screwed over the pattern. So I knew I wasn't going to win that time. It was just terrible luck. Absolutely terrible luck that she went to the corner like that. I'm not gonna lie, it's the fucking audio too. It's like mad annoying at the end. It gets so fucking loud that you can't even concentrate. Cause now you got the fucking lightning sound effect, you get the fucking area effect sound effect, you got the roaring, you got the atmospheric music. It's like, I think I'm gonna take the headphones off. I seriously do. It fucking pisses me off. I'm trying to concentrate on a boss fight and I gotta hear loud, like fucking 10 decibels higher than what I was listening to a second ago. It actually hurts. But I had it. The problem was, you saw what happened at the end, she did the flatten attack, and when I was trying to get to the side to heal, she just decided to do another attack that usually she doesn't do, so. But I'm getting closer, all I gotta do is keep whittling her down till you get to that final form, and then just keep it on it, keep on it, so. Alright. Alright, let's keep going, guys. So that last run was the best one by far. If I can just keep her in that pattern, I'll win, it's just that I got some bad luck at the end. Turn my audio way fucking down from being so goddamn loud. And on top of everything else, let's make the audio like insanely loud for no reason during this boss. Wrong spot. Yeah, dude, this was bad luck. I ended up in the wrong spot. I'm about to just fucking kill me now. If I remember, you can just roll the head, but I think you have to target it for it to work. It's like really hard. This is way better with low volume. It seriously is. I knew that was gonna happen. I knew that was gonna happen. That's why I didn't want to heal. I knew all of a sudden she was gonna randomly do that stupid bullshit attack from the other side. That's why I didn't want to bother healing. If I had gotten her down to where she did the area of effect, then I would have started healing, but I didn't want to waste it. Seriously, it's much easier. Actually, the fight is way easier on you with low volume because it's too fucking loud. It's like the audio director of the game is a troll. He's like, oh, it's a really hard boss fight, so what I'll do is I'll pump up all the audio to annoy the fuck out of the gamer and give you a headache when you're trying to fucking fight this boss. Here's what I want. I want a From Software game, the hardest boss in the game while you're trying to do it. All you hear is a guy dancing in the background. He goes, neener, 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 fuck you, you're gonna die, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. And he just does that the whole boss fight. And it takes like 10 minutes to kill the boss. That's what I want. Neener, neener, fuck you. Neener, neener, fuck you, you suck, fuck you. Oh shit, my weapons are ransomed. That's not good. We gotta go heal after this. Well, I'm not winning this time anyway. Somehow it hit. I don't even understand why that hit. Fuck you, you're fighting a tough boss. Fuck you, gamer, fuck you, you gave us your money, fuck you. Why not? It should be Patches. Patches dancing up there. Fuck you, up-a-da-ba-da. That would be the ultimate boss fight. Can you survive? No, it's not my day. Tolo, it's not my day at all, man. It's just not my day. I'm just trying to whip the shit out of a giant alien with a fucking cane. It's all I want. It's all I want to do. Is that too much to ask to just take a giant alien and take a cane and just fucking beat the shit out of it like Ebenezer Scrooge? I mean, that's not an unreasonable request. Why can't I just do that? But no, instead, I gotta have loud audio annoying me. I gotta have heat in my office. Come on. Come on. Alex Master says maybe put the better gems on the cane. I guess that's a good point. I put my better gems in the fucking Blades of Mercy. Maybe I should put the better gems in the cane. Or I could just do a video get lucky. That's what it's gonna take. Not to be that was coming, yep. Because I remember this fight very well. When I beat her, she never used that attack. When the time that I actually finally beat her, she never used the laser attack at all. Because the laser attack is pretty much, I mean, you just have to get away from her. But by the time you get away from her, then you can never get in close again. So you have to basically hope she doesn't do it or you're completely fucked. Yeah, when I beat her, she never used the lasers at all. Maybe I will put better gems on the cane. I think you're getting a good recommendation here. After the... Alright, if I lose again, which I'm going to... Oh my god, fucking asshole. If I die here, I'll go back and I'll try to swap the gems out. Put the better gems on the cane. The only actual penguin says just run when she does the lasers, they're no big deal. No, I know that. The problem isn't dodging the laser. The problem is when you're out of the sweet spot, when she's in her final form, it's actually very hard to get back to her side. Because she's got area effect damage, plus her swipes get way more intense. Her headbutts and shit. You know. She's around a lot more than that, too. She'll, like, hit her a lot more. Yeah, this is good shit. I got out of the sweet spot and I'm screwed, so... not be the run. Yep. Nope. Nope. Alright, let me see if I switch the gems. Alright. Now I got the gems, I got the paper, I got the health. Now I just need to get lucky. Which, that was an incredibly bad start. I wasn't in the spot yet. What an incredibly bad start to the fight. I wonder if you could parry her. I never tried. I wonder if you can parry her. I mean, she's ginormous. Maybe there's certain attacks you can parry. I doubt you could parry all the attacks, right? I hate that attack. That's the cheapest attack. You don't get to heal after it. See that? You don't lose your blood back after it. I'm fucked. In the corner. I'm fucked. Dude, what the hell? Look where she is now. Did she even get out of there? No, look. Look, she's doing it again. attack and shoot a fist, and it just happened to hit me on the very edge, and immediately does headbutt. So it comboed. It hit me, and then before I could dodge, headbutt. Instant kill. It was like a fucking Street Fighter 2-in-1. There's nothing I could do about it at all. I'm stuck now. I'm getting robbed. Yep. Yep. I'm done. I got robbed. As soon as she went into the area of effective damage attack, she started doing the fucking, she started doing the swipe, which hits you twice. So, it's just, again, bad luck. I just need to get her back into the pattern where she still does the swipe that doesn't hit me. It was just more bad luck. The bottom line is, again, I can be good at games if I want to. If I actually want to take a minute to try to be serious with it, I can do it. So this is actually, honestly, this is much harder than my first run because of the limited weapons that I had. If I had better weapons now, I probably would be doing way better, but because I'm limited to what I can use, because I did a legit run with no grinding, it didn't give me the flexibility to level up good weapons, so I'm stuck using shit ones, and taking forever to beat this fucking bitch. Eternal Napalm Destruction, and Ebrietas, Daughter of the Cosmos, is tons of fun. Yeah, she was the hardest boss for me in the first game. She seriously was. In the first game, in the first run. But now I think I'm much more equipped to take her on. What's hilarious is people are complaining just like they did in my first run. Why is it Phil healing? Why is it because I'm just fucking practicing.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Ooh, oh my god. Stop fucking lying.
Wow! I'm done. It did 99% damage and then got a grab on me. Wow! When has that ever happened before? Seriously, when does that ever happen? That's not happened. And I just fought her how many times? She decides, I'm going to do a 99% damage attack and then grab you when you're getting up. What the fuck was that? She never did that before. Never. Okay. Fucking delightful. Well, hooray, we went up one sub. Thanks, guys. And we're still at the same top cheerer and the same top tipper, I believe. Yeah, and of course, you walked right into her grab. Actually, no, I didn't. I didn't do it anything there. I got knocked down, and I was never able to move. She literally just grabbed me right from the spot where I was knocked down as I was getting up. There was no way I could get out of the way. Well, it seems like it's going to take me just as many deaths this time to kill her as it did the first time. But again, it's not because, I'm worse at the game or anything, just because... What the fuck? You see that? She lifted me off the ground. What the fuck is that? That's never happened before. That's because I have... I didn't know it was three shots. No, I thought it was two, so I stopped running after the second one. It's three levels a shot, okay. I didn't know that. Didn't fucking know that. Now I know. Okay, that time I didn't get anything back. No idea, because I couldn't see because the camera is so happy.
the fucking lasers, so I couldn't do anything about it. Do you guys see why I don't heal? I'm not gonna heal till I'm near the end, and I know that I have a legit chance to win. But I got fucked there, she went against the wall, fucked me over, camera got stuck. Got her! There we go. Just had to be patient, I had to turn my volume back up. Very good. Everyone's going crazy, why? I already beat her. It's not a big deal. Thank you, Infinite, for 1,000 bits here. And I got an anonymous $6.60 tip in celebration. I've been fighting her for what? What, guys? By half hour at least? I'd say half hour to 45 minutes, and I beat her now. Finally. I've been fighting her for what? What, guys? By half hour at least? I'd say half hour to 45 minutes, and I beat her now. Finally.
Really, nigga?
And I got FJ Resto just give me a $10 tip. So congrats, Phil Perseverance. Alright, well, let's update everything then. Thank you, guys. Appreciate that. Let's see here. So, thank you to Infinite for that 55-bit cheer, whoever did that anonymous chip as well. Oops. There we go. Thank you, everybody, for your support. I beat her. I knew I was going to. I told you it was a matter of time. It was a matter of time of me remembering her attacks and timing everything properly, so, and getting lucky, too. So, okay. And some people are like, oh my god, is that the hardest Phil's ever had? No. To champion Gundyr in Dark Souls 3, that took like 3 hours. That was almost an entire stream. No lie, that was like 2.5 to 3 hours I was fighting that motherfucker. I'm back here. Jaybird asked, do I have less deaths than the first time fighting her? I think I do. I think I have less deaths. I'm almost positive I do. Because I remember it taking a couple hours for me to beat it the first time. I could be wrong, though. Alright, so the question is, what should I level now, guys? What do you guys think? Well, first let me go put my gems back the way they were. Waluigi, you are stupid. That's all I'm gonna say. Alright.
Overly sensitive.
Is there a door or something? I don't see anything. Damn. No. They're stuck. Shit. No! Wow! I got pounded and added to the meat wagon. They just added my, assimilated my body. They said, come here. God damn. God damn. I got fucked up. I got fucked up bad. Damn. Oh. Ouch. Okay then. Alright. Oh shit! Fucker was waiting for me! God damn, he scared me! Oh shit! Seems like of all of them, he has the trickiest moveset. What? That made no sense. Of course. Oh, I don't see him. Look, it's Slash from Aerosmith. Okay. So I gotta find the guy who killed me. I'm on my fucking revenge. I believe he's hiding behind these things. I wanna kill this guy. And I wanna explore the back. Remember where Dark Beast Parle was? I wanna explore all that back area. The Blood Moon is at its zenith. Summon a great one from the moon, but they don't exactly get what they had intended. They're thinking, oh, it's gonna be a fucking alien, right? No, get this instead. Do this fucking thing. That don't look like a great one to me. It's like a great sack of shit. Ebrietas. If you actually look at it, it almost is the body type of Ebrietas a little bit. It's just that it's made of humans. That douche kid just cheered. He said, every time trolls come out in chat, I feel the urge to tip or cheer to troll the trolls. There you go.
Thanks for the money, dummy.
Have audience with superior being, but remember special item. 3/3 chords. These are the tips. These are the tips to get you the secret ending and fight the moon presence. Yep.
No shit.
That worked. Did I have the frenzy resistant? Oh! The frenzy resistant armor on. I'm doing good. Bye bye. We got a big doof over here. Yep, I remember this guy. What? Dude, that's horse shit. Wow! Dude, saw that, right? The Rock moved in midair. The Rock literally moved in midair and hit me in the head. That's bullshit. That is some cheap shit right there, dude. It fucking moved in midair and tracked me and hit me. What the fuck? A homing rock toss. Get the fuck out of here. Wait a minute, come back. Oh, you cheap son of a bitch. Alright, now I gotta kill the big one. Alright, am I the only one who thinks it looks really stupid when it rotates? I got cheated. Yep. I got cheated. 100% cheated. Stupid fucking game. It magically tracked me. It magically fucking tracked me as I was running around it. Bullshit. Fucking stupid. All that slow fucking work to try to kill it and then I die like that. It's fucking bullshit. I'm tired of it. I'm fucking tired of it. That's it. I've had it with you, From Software. I've had it with you. I'm coming for you. What the fuck? Dude, you think it has enough reach? Those stupid shaman blades I don't need. Excuse me, shaman blades. I call them shaman, everyone makes fun of me. He said shaman. He said shaman. It's hilarious, a shaman. Shaman. Yaman shaman blades. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Bloodborne, the Redemption Run. For full clarification purposes, if you're on stream, you probably already know this, but if you're watching this on demand on YouTube at your own leisure, I've not played this game for a week and a half, okay? I've been busy with God of War, the other major new release that came out and kind of trumped everything for about a week. So I'm going back into this after a week and a half of not playing it, and I get the feeling I'm going to suck. Like, I just get the feeling that I'm going to be, like, really rusty, and I'm probably going to get owned, all right? But, oh, that's right, I gotta add in the death counter. Thank you, Jim Bob, for reminding me. It's 119. I know that for a fact that we're at 119 deaths. Hold on.
Wrong!
Well, that was great. I just love that he has reach that's way further than what actually it shows. Because you see how he's holding his scythe? Where he only has a little bit, so technically he should have very short range. But then when he actually goes like this, for some reason the scythe extends in his hands and like doubles in. I thought I remember this part being really tough. Apparently it's not. I don't know. I thought I remembered it being really tough before when I did it in my first run. But now they're just like not doing shit. Very odd. Oh look, the troll is back. And the troll is banned.
Why am I toxic?
Oh, you have a hilarious name that if I cheer, Phil will read this name and people will take it out of context for hilarious antics on the internet later. Oh, banned. Like, overly sensitive. Oops. What's also funny is that guy apparently is a 3-month sub, when in reality he probably had a different name and changed it. Because I would have recognized that name before if he had used it. What the fuck is that? Now that guy looks like he's gonna hurt me. I don't remember this guy either. Oh my god, look at that damage. Good god, did he do a ton of damage. One hit. Oh, I used the sedative by accident. Ah. Dude, sedatives are... I told you, I haven't played this in a week and a half. I knew I was going to fuck up. And I did. Wasting a sedative is a big problem. Sedatives you need later on for those brain dudes. And I wasted a freaking sedative like an idiot. Oh, here we go.
Some say Cosm.
Oh, some say Cosm, yes. Here he's talking about a great one. He's trying to contact a great one.
No, we shall not abandon the dream. No one can catch us. No one can stop us now.
The knowledge of the great one turned him completely nuts. Trying to communicate with the aliens, he lost his mind. Or cause, or some say cosm. Alright. Just gonna have to try to chase him down. Ha! Ah! That's fucking what's happening to the stamina. The thing is, I can actually run faster than him, but he has infinite stamina. Please run endless. Oh, you fucker! You little fucker! Oh my god, what? Now what was that? All of a sudden it made a sound like I got parried. What the hell? It made a parry sound effect out of nowhere. And I lost all my health. What the fuck? That was some random shit. The problem there was I couldn't get the targeting to stay. You know, the targeting wouldn't stay on him. And so, basically I lost track of where he was. I wasn't able to fucking finish him. That sucked. Random ass parry out of nowhere. So I don't need to fight any of these guys. Even if they got the chain, I'll just run right by them.
Oh, really?
That was complete bullshit. Wow! You want to talk about bullshit? It showed he came down with it, and the hitbox was behind me. Or at least the visual hitbox was behind me. And apparently the hitbox is wider than the actual axe. And it hit my toe, and the next thing I know, I got comboed. Now that was fucking stupid. That was really stupid.
Stupid.
Stupid. Tremendously dumb. This sucks because the shortcut isn't open, see? Oh wait, can this work now? Oh, never mind. I didn't know there was a lever here. God damn it. If I knew the lever was there, I obviously would have never went that way anyway. Oh well. Ridiculous.
You better take a sip. You fucking sleazy asshole.
I forgot that there was a lever there to pull down the shortcut thing. Well, 5 years or 3 years away will do that. I got owned. Dickhead, look. One of them fight me. Oh, I tried to roll, nothing happened. I He's not dead. Oh. Gonna go to a different area now. Yep. I got also did a 25-minute chase. What did I miss? You're just missing me chase this asshole, that's all. Nothing too interesting. Oh man, two more big boys. Well, one big boy and one ranged asshole. Let me get him back so the ranged asshole doesn't hit me. Alright. I tried to roll, it didn't work. I just tried to roll! Oh my god! Complete bullshit. I tried to fucking roll, and as soon as he started lifting the club, I did it, and nothing happened. I was stuck in a stupid animation. Oh my god, dude. So dumb, because he's not even, they're not even tough enemies. Oh, randomly, you can't roll now, so here, take fucking 90% damage. Stupid. So now I gotta do it over from the start again. At least I got more blood vials. Plague Wielder did 125-bit cheer. It said, Grantos death! Grantos death! Grantos cheers! Grantos cheers! A really annoying boss. I think a lot of people hate this boss, too. One of the most annoying parts of the game. Boys, grant us, boys, grant us, boys.
Over here, bitch.
Wow, rolling away, still got hit. Whoa, what the fuck? I held right and pressed roll, he rolled straight. The guy's not even tough. If the control would fucking do what I tell it, I wouldn't be losing 90% of my fucking health, stupid game. So dumb. He's right in front of me. Roll right. No, roll straight and I get hit. Fucking stupid.
Majestic! Hunter is a hunter, even in a dream.
Alright, going up this way. Alas. What? Why'd he get super armor? Why? Why'd he all of a sudden get super armor? That was fucking stupid.
I've got the beast in my sights.
Yes, I got hit. Of course I did. Around a corner. It's full of shit.
Instant replay, please.
Yes, I got hit. Of course I did. I'm rolling. Oh my god. This is pissing me off now. Ignore my move. Oh my god, fuck this! Dude, seriously, this is stupidity. This is stupidity. Yes, he tracks my movement and it spins in place and hits me for 60-70% damage. Fucking dumb as fuck. I'm done with this. I'm not using these fucking blades no more. I'm going back to the stupid fucking cane. I'm whipping the shit out of everything. Now I'm pissed. I'm seriously pissed off. A normal enemy in a confined space kills me because of a stupid fucking garbage attack pattern. Get the fuck out of here. Waste of my time. It's not even the boss that's fucking me, it's the stupid ass fucking game, the controls and shit. It's so annoying. I know, because again, I'm so spoiled by playing games that have like good reaction time and shit, and I always forget that the From Software games, there's innate delay between when you press the button and when something happens on screen. Like, watch this, ready? See that? There's delay. But that's only From Software. I've been playing God of War, and it's not like that at all. In God of War, I've been getting stuff like right away. These games, they built that in to make it so fucking annoying. So I hit him 4 or 5 times. Oh, time to roll out of the way. Oh, my roll comes out super late, so I get hit for 90% damage. Great game. And I used the healing item by accident. What? He was falling, and then all of a sudden he decided not to fall. Oh? I got hit from behind, I guess. Great. I gotta waste more fucking potions. I healed again by accident. Oh my god. He ignored my whip. Like, I wasn't even doing it. Yup, he did it again.
I've got the beast in my sights.
Wow, I got hit. Get the fuck out of here. This fucking game, dude. I got hit. They just keep ignoring my attacks and attacking through with super armor. I have 2 healing things left. I'm not gonna win this now. I'm not. I'm gonna have to go buy potions. Stupid as this fucking thing is, I'm gonna have to buy them. Wait a minute, doesn't he... He teleports around through these mirrors, doesn't he? I think I remember that. He jumps through the mirrors. He's really annoying. There he is. Yup, so if I had a ranged attack here, I could fuck him with ranged moves and poison him if I had poison daggers. I don't have anything. Look at that, it's a glitch. He just keeps running out of the same mirror, so if I had infinite throwing items, I could kill him right here. Yeah, that's pretty cheap. He glitches out and runs through the same mirror, so I can just keep hitting him with infinite throwing items, but I don't have enough. All I have left is 3-4 throwing knives, that's it. This guy's stuck in the fucking wall, look. He can't get out of the wall. The music is too high, people are saying. Yeah, because the game's fucking has a terrible volume balance. That's why the music's too high. They do this during every boss fight, and it's fucking mad annoying. Like, I'm all for epic boss music, but this shit's way too loud in this game. Oh my god, it's so annoying! This is why people hate this boss. This is the most annoying shit in the game. I seriously hate this shit. I can't remember how to get in there. Oh, great! He fucking does it twice. He does the same exact move twice in a row. And it hits me twice while I'm stunned and I can't move. Oh my god. The most annoying fucking thing in the game. It's not even tough, it's just fucking annoying. I totally understand why people hate this. By the way, shout out to Owl Eye Guy, who cheered. He said, go back to where the bridge comes up and stick right. Oh, thank you, Owl Eye Guy. I already figured it out. Grantos, cheers. Grantos, cheers. Oh my god. It's so annoying, dude. So now I gotta waste blood to buy fucking potions. I just love wasting it. might as well waste all of them. Seriously, just max out on potions. Fucking mad annoying game. I am. I'm just gonna waste it all. That way I don't have to worry about this shit. How many can I buy? 54. Look at that. Now I won't have to worry about that shit again. I'm just gonna do it. Fuck it. I seriously don't even care. There. There's also a bunch of idiots who are cheering, or not cheering, but are screaming in stream chat to use the music box because they think I'm stupid. Guys, you already tried that 400 times during the playthrough before. It's not gonna work. Why am I toxic? What? Where the fuck is he in the room?
Cosmos, of course.
Shut the fuck up.
What did you say, nigga?
Wow, I'm dead. He trapped me in the corner with that stupid shit. Yeah, he trapped me in the corner. You gotta stay away from him and dodge to the sides to dodge that magic, then rush in and hit him. The problem is I was trying to get my fucking stupid blood shards. I don't know why I bothered. I probably shouldn't have bothered trying to get the blood shards. I should have just said fuck it and tried to kill him. But I was so concerned with the blood shards that I didn't just rush him. I probably just should have. Yes, blood echo, blood shards, whatever the fuck it's called, I don't care. Outlaw guy, I don't even know what you're talking about. Thank you for the cheer, but I have no idea what you're talking about. I never even heard of the term soy boy. I don't even know what the fuck that means. I really don't. I'm not in on really stupid memes on the internet, so I have no idea what that means. Fuck, he attacked before I was even in up the stairs.
Oh, Cos.
Shut up with your Cosm bullshit. I landed on him, did you see that? Wow. That was fair. It's bullshit because you hit him and he should be staggered just like you, but instead he instantly recovers and then can combo into an attack. So I hit you with this, then I hit you with this, you're instantly dead. Wow, thanks. Really stupid. The stupidest boss of the fucking game, he's just annoying as fuck. The garbage obligatory. Oh, From Software wants to do something different, so let's make a puzzle boss. That's not actually a boss, he's just annoying as fuck. No, California Thunderqueer, the music box doesn't deflect magic. Thank you for the cheer, but I know you're trolling. Har har har. Har har har.
Thanks for the money, dummy.
Whoa, for some reason you have a... Whoa! California. California. What the fuck is going on here? I'm a retard. There you go. Jeez. California. It's a very exciting place, California, if you guys aren't aware.
Ugh.
such a pain in the ass to have to redo it over and fucking over and fucking over. I remember my first playthrough was just as bad. The guy annoyed me just as much. It was a crazy waste of time. Got him. Annoying bastard. Yeah, because he's stuck in the infinite nightmare. If you remember when we first got to this area, we got it from the street. Remember that we were in the unseen village? And we find his dead body in that building at the end of the unseen village. And then we go inside his nightmare. And that's where we are right now, a virtual world. Much like we went into the frontier, the nightmare frontier. This is the nightmare of Mensis. So this isn't real, any of this. And so what he's saying is, oh no, I killed him. So now he's going to wake up from the nightmare and forget everything. Like all the stuff he learned about the aliens. And all the insight and shit, he thinks he's gonna forget it. What he doesn't know is he's dead. In real life, his body died. So he's just done. He's fucked. Oh, sure. Outlaw guy cheered and said victory, and also BNIY cheered and said yay. So thank you guys. And Symbios the Rex just cheered 210 bits and said, got him that poo bum life hater. And I can wear the Mensis cage.
Grantos cheers. Grantos cheers.
Oh, thank you, Silent General. Just did a 500-bit cheer and became the cheerleader. Thank you. Wow. Here we go. Nice troll cheer. Phil Fears Society said, how many onions do you use when you make your sauce?
Because it's all about the onion. Doesn't matter if you're a woman or a man, you need to consume onions. You may not like it, but this is what peak performers look like.
Hilarious. Actually, the truth is I only use one white onion. But thank you, Silent General, for top tier. You will now get the top tier spot. I could upgrade the threaded cane one more time, which I think I might do. Evelyn needs some blood. Zebra asks, can I make the Persona 5 playlist public? I will eventually. I just keep forgetting to do it, quite frankly. I might do it if people keep reminding me. I might do it because I am going to resume Persona 5 this summer, I've decided. All right, so let's take a look. All right, guys, if you want to joke about the onion thing, I will now allow you to joke about the onion thing. Quite frankly, I don't even understand the whole joke behind the onion thing anyway. I don't watch PewDiePie videos. I never will. I have a brain in my head that I like to keep firmly in the head and not melt out the fucking ears. So I will never watch a PewDiePie video. So go right ahead and joke about it. I have no idea what you're talking about. Just if you're going to joke about it, don't completely spam and bombard the stream chat with it. Every once in a while, you want to make a joke about onions or whatever. I don't care. But if you make it the entirety of the stream that, it's going to just derail everything and people aren't going to have a good time, alright? Fair enough, guys. Yeah, I don't get it either because I didn't see the video. I don't know what it's supposed to mean. I'm sure it's an insult. PewDiePie has insulted me many times in the past and probably will never stop considering it gives some cheap views. You know, when you have a lack of talent and you have to constantly put out videos for the masses, and you know, you just want to insult people, you do videos like that. So it is what it is. No, Hazar, you're completely wrong. Wasn't Redemption Run supposed to be a run where Phil just figures everything out for himself and the chat is closed? No, it was never that. Redemption Run was, number one, I don't grind. Number two, I do the Old Hunters DLC. That's what the Redemption Run was. And I said that a million times, but apparently you just don't pay any attention. So it's your own fault. Like, overly sensitive. Philidomancer says I should just make an onion emote just to capitalize off of the meme. I guess I could. We should make an onion emote just for people to come in and be like, here's the guy, get back on the onion. And then they'll subscribe and use the onion emote. Because that's the mentality of the PewDiePie fan, I guess. I mean, I could use an onion emote. I'm gonna subscribe immediately. Good lord. I don't know, man. Oh, shit. Thank you, Silent General, for a $10 tip. Silent General, the only tipper for today, is now finally going to get on the leaderboard here. Let's go ahead and do that. Thank you very much, Silent General.
Thanks for the money, dummy.
So, top, she's the current top tier and top dipper. Although, it's certainly not unattainable to knock him out of there, but there you go. Thank you, Silent General. I believe this is the area with the brain dudes. Yeah, this is it. 100%, this is the bridge with the brain dudes. I remember this. They're coming up. There's the giant brain right there. Well, there's not much I can do about that. I was being gangbanged not only by the giant brain, but also by this asshole. Not a thing I'm remembering. I think I remember if you get through this area, you pull the lever that drops the giant brain, and it stops the frenzy stuff from happening ever again. And then you could come back afterward and not... So I don't have to loot those items yet. If I drop the brain, then I won't be attacked by it again. Octoa just cheered with a detractor meme. Ack, ack, ack. You're not the top cheer anymore, are you? Hilarious, Octoa. We all, as you know, we all laugh out loud hilariously when the ack, ack, ack meme is used. And even though I don't laugh saying ack, ack, ack at all, it's literally something that some idiot made up and said that I sound like, when in reality I don't sound like that at all. But thank you for the top cheer. Okay. We'll try this again now. Now I gotta go all the fucking way back down, don't I? What a pain in the ass. No, I don't. When I laugh, it does not sound like ack, ack, ack. It was like ack, 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 ack. That's not what it sounds like when I laugh. When I laugh, I go ah, 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 ah. So if anything, I would say I sound like the count from fucking Sesame Street. You know, it goes, one... One, whatever I'm counting. Two. Two, whatever the fuck it is I'm counting. That's how I laugh. I don't laugh like ack. There's no CK in what I'm doing at all. But again, people are so dumb. They follow this weird mom mentality because one guy said it and it was, he said it. Now we all have to repeat it. So now everyone repeats this dumb thing that's not even true. I don't sound like that at all. If you want to make fun of me, call me the count from Sesame Street. So there you go. Alright, I gotta do some shoutouts. The first thing I'm gonna try to do is get the fucking crosshair right now. Fuck! So there's spiders and these assholes here. What a pain in the dick this is gonna be. This is gonna be a major pain in the ass, dude. Yeah, we got a cheer war breaking out in stream chat. This is the worst time for it to happen because I can't pay attention. There we go. I need the transformed cane. There we go. Those are these guys. Dumb, 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 you are dumb. That's what they're saying. Dumb, 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 you are dumb. Fuck. Alright, well now that I'm stuck here, I guess I'll do some shoutouts. Hold on. So, let's see here. Alex Master cheered. He said, you should spend some more insight. The more insight you have, the lower your frenzy resist by a lot. Yeah, I know. You're actually right. If I have very low insight here, these guys wouldn't even be hurting me. King Swaggins just did a 502-bit cheer. He said, that was messed up. To get that ass off the leaderboard. Octoa did a 503-bit cheer. He said, Dagakotowaru. Then King Swaggins did a 504-bit cheer. He said, new badge height. I guess he earned himself a new badge. Octoa did a 505-bit cheer and said, Nani? And then King Swaggins did a 619-bit cheer. But then Octoa just dropped the cheer bomb, a 5,000-bit cheer. Dollar, dollar, dollar. That's what I need. Hey, hey. I said, Omae wa mu shinderu. Holy crap. Well, obviously, thank you guys very much for your support. Let's now update the cheer leaderboard. Oktoa is very massively in the lead right now. And quite frankly, I doubt anyone's going to be beating a 5,000 bit cheer today. So thank you for that, Oktoa. Anyone wants to actually beat it, maybe you should look more towards the tipping aspect, if you know what I mean. All right. But thank you, both King Swaggins and Oktoa, for that little cheer war. Appreciate that, man.
Thanks for the money, dummy.
I roll. Oh, I'm dead. It's over. Frenzy's gonna kill me. Got him. What a pain in the fucking ass that guy is. Whoa, my God, King Swaggins just did a 5,001 bit cheer. Are you shitting me? Thank you, Swaggins. Whoa, thank you both Oktoa and Swaggins. Obviously, you guys are being super supportive, but I did not expect Swaggins to just do that. And Swaggins is now the cheerleader for today. Holy crap, man. I don't know what it is about Bloodborne and PUBG, but these streams really bring out the support. All right, wow. Thank you. Okay. Symbios just tipped me $22. Wow, Symbios, thank you. Now Symbios is the cheerleader for today, the tip leader for today. Thank you very much, Symbios. Let's go ahead and get them up on the leaderboard. The brain's right there. I'm pretty sure that was it. I need to drop right there. I need to drop down there. But the fucking frenzy got my ass. Fuck. That's it. You gotta run out. I think there's a door. You run out and there's a lever and it drops the brain. Yeah, I got fucked right there. Alright. Gotta go back again. I don't need this insight anymore and I'll take way less damage from the frenzy. So I think I'm going to. Plus, like I said, there's also the brain guys are coming up. The fucking brain guys are coming up. And I know that they're gonna kill me quick too, so. Alright. Holy crap! I just got a $100 tip from Blaine. What's going on, Blaine? Good to see you here. Yeah, I've seen you actually more recently on streams. More often. Thank you very much, Blaine, for the tip, man. Alright, so Blaine, 007 Blaine, is our top tipper for today. $100, thank you.
I need $1.
Thanks for the money, dummy.
Wow, people are super supportive today. Thanks, guys. This is not a product placement whatsoever, folks. No product placement for my Teespring whatsoever right now. Nope. None. All right. Now I should be good with only 4 insight. I mean, why am I smoking? What the fuck is this? All right, now let's see if this helps me. Okay, fucking shit. Wait a minute. I was here already. I went the wrong way. I don't know. I've already been here. This ain't the right way. What the fuck? How the fuck did I get here? This is bullshit. Wait a minute. I fell off a ledge or something. Right? I'm not supposed to be here. What happened? How did I even end up here? All I got is that door is not the real way to get to the brain. What the fuck? How did I went through a hole in a wall, and next thing I know, I'm down here. What the fuck? This sucks. I wasted a ton of healing, and it's fucking... This is bullshit. Yeah, I fell here. I wasn't supposed to. I don't remember what to do. This part of the game is really annoying, man. I don't remember what to do. This sucks. I don't know where to go to do this brain part. It's all a fucking crazy-ass annoying puzzle. This whole part of the game is, like, the most annoying. It really is. The next part's straightforward because you just go on a gauntlet trying to get up to the wet nurse. But this part right now is just a pain in the fucking ass. This isn't it. See, I know there's a shortcut, but... See, you know, everyone in the street chat spamming stuff and no one's being specific? Go in the elevator with a broken door and roll off halfway up. Where? What are you talking about? It's not this elevator. So what on earth are you talking about? Saying stuff like that doesn't help if you don't actually tell me where it is. And that's what frustrates me when people try to backseat when I'm playing these games. Like, this isn't it. It's not where I am. So what on earth are you talking about? Like, I know right here there's an elevator, but I can't activate it. I need to operate this elevator, I think, to do what they're talking about. And here's where you roll off, right here. And I missed. Wow, he took the plunge. Dude, he landed at the lantern at the bottom. Ow. Dude, he landed all the way at the bottom. That's brutal. Oh, dude. What a plunge. What a fucking plunge.
But wait! There's more!
There we go again! Oh, yeah! I am not aligned properly. Oh, yeah! Who wants a hunter pancake? A bag of bones. A big bag of bones. Well, I'm dead. I did it too early. I grabbed again. I can't see. Oh my god, so what happened? I could do a guy fucking got summoned out of nowhere. He got summoned out of nowhere. I got fucked. It's like it's not hard enough to do this bridge on your own, then a fucking guy gets summoned too randomly. Fucking annoying. Like, how the fuck am I supposed to do that? No way. No way. Yeah, I'm not gonna complain. This is the only time during the playthrough I've even gotten invaded, so. DSP is really cool. I already answered that on pre-stream. He's asking if I'm going to try the Chalice Dungeons. I have no idea. The thing is, I know the Chalice Dungeons are boring for people to watch. The first playthrough, people were mad bored when I tried the Chalice Dungeons. They told me, you know, don't do them. They're boring. So, I don't know. I tried them my first playthrough, and they weren't very successful. I got to a certain point, and I kept losing to a boss, and basically the views dropped off, and no one cared. So, I don't know if I'll be doing Chalice Dungeons this time around. Yes, I remember to use the make contact email, Alex Master, once I get to the big brain. Thanks. Roll, dude! Look! Get the fuck out of here. I was pressing it. I was pressing it. I'm doing it! It didn't do it again! It's fucking up, dude. It's complete horseshit. What?! Okay, it went through all the rocks and still hit me. It went through all the rocks and still hit me. By the way, that was the last one. All I needed to do was get by that, and I could do it. I got completely robbed. What the fuck? What? Why did he roll again? I didn't roll again. I never rolled a second time, so now I'm gonna die. Yeah, I'm dead. Frenzy's gonna get me. I'm dodging. Didn't work. I attacked three times and I pressed dodge. It didn't attack, or it didn't dodge. So fucking stupid. Dodge! Oh my god. Oh, it didn't work! I got robbed! I dodged! I'm dead now. Oh boy, here comes an invasion. Fuck me. Probably like Sir fucking Sir Taint Sniffer. Kal-El. Oh my god, they're synchronized pigs. It's Kal-El and synchronized pigs. Look at this guy. Fuck this shit. Not even a point in trying. There really isn't. You know the guy's probably like massively overwhelmed. I didn't even bother. I didn't even, you notice I didn't heal. I didn't care. I didn't care. Shut up. Wow! Instant death! That pig's with a bunch of eyeballs. The pig with 100 eyeballs on his face. That was an instant death from that pig. 100% damage. Holy fuck. Instant. Wow. Not even a chance. He's like, fuck you, death. Death, motherfucker, death. Why would I do, DSP is really cool. Why would I ever do a redemption run of Bioshock 1? I just played that recently in the remastered edition and it was a fine playthrough. Like, the reason I do redemption runs is because I fucked up the first playthrough. You know, like, I did something wrong. I did something that people didn't deem as, oh, that was a good playthrough, you know. There's absolutely no reason for me to go back and replay certain games. Bioshock 1, I don't think anyone wants to see me go back and play that. Let's find out. I mean, I'm okay going and doing redemption runs as long as there's a game that, like, oh, I played it and I did bad in it, or people don't like the playthrough because one way a thing went one way or another. In this case, oh, hello. Yeah, you have to find, like, and then for example, some people have always had issues with the Bloodborne playthrough because I grinded. I grinded like crazy, right? So a lot of people didn't like that. Now I'm not grinding anymore, so it's a very different experience. Plus, I'm learning parrying and stuff. People wanted to see Redemption Run of the original Dark Souls, so I never actually played it from start to finish without getting my hand held, you know? So now things are a little different. The Captain of Soul asked, will I do a Dead Space Redemption Run? Dead Space 1? No. Because I already replayed that, but I would do Dead Space 2. In fact, I'm seriously considering, after I finish up Bloodborne, God of War, or both, the next game I play is Dead Space 2. I think so. Alright, Murgos Wet Nurse. Then we go to the DLC. We gotta get past this boss hurdle first. The Captain of Soul says, I don't know if this was asked, but Metal Gear Solid 1 Redemption Run. I already did it. Dude, that was the first thing I did this... Oh, no, that's right. No, I didn't. Let me take that back. I played 2 and 3 this year. Metal Gear Solid 1, again. Redemption Run for a game that I didn't do so bad in, I don't think would be worthy. DSP is really cool, so please do the DLC. DLC I Am, that's next. In fact, there's time for some of it on the stream today. And the Captain of Salt just also did a 25-bit share and said DLC. Don't worry, the DLC is coming right now. But anyway. Great. All right. Ally guy. Oh, wait a minute. DSP is really cool, Chaser. Why do people call you Dave? I don't get half the memes. It was a mistake. Someone accidentally called me Dave on a stream a million years ago, and everyone just ran with it. It's silly, but it's not malicious or anything. Yes, completely. Fuck off. Noisy idiot. That's all he's a noisy idiot. Shut the fuck up. AES Charity said, what's the difference between a game being hard and a game being cheap? Difficult is, okay, you're going up against a bunch of enemies, but there's a fair way to beat it. You know what I mean? Like, it's not an insanely, like, for example, okay, there's five enemies on this bridge. You go head up against them, you fight them, and it's challenging, but if you time your dodges, if you parry everything, you can win. Now, oh, you go up to this bridge, and you're fighting five guys, all of a sudden a dragon flies over and insta-kills you with flame. That's cheap. There's no way you would know that's coming. There's no way to prepare for it. There's no way to counter it. You're just fucked. What in the holy hell? See what I mean? That's cheap. There's no way you would know this guy's completely immune to backstabs. There's no fucking way on earth you would ever know that. You know? A pebble, you fucking piece of shit. What is this? What? You gotta be joking. I rolled away. She still grabbed through the roll like I never did it. I can't move. What a stupid bitch.
And now, our feature presentation.
Is this a boss? Is this Ludwig? Did I make it? Guys, this is it? Alright, hold on. I can fucking go back to my real weapon. Fuck that! Go back to the real weapon if I'm gonna fight fucking Ludwig. So the good news is, I don't have to go too far. I go from the shortcut gate right down to the water, the blood river. I just gotta get past the two big oafs, really. And then I could go right to Ludwig. Alright. Alright. Are we ready for this shit? I'm gonna try with the Blades of Mercy too, which is probably a huge mistake. Alright, here we go. Ludwig with the Blades of Mercy. Yeah. Alright, guys. The time is now. 3 years in the making. Time to lose.
Help us.
Oh, there was a lantern, people are saying. I didn't find it. He's an unsightly beast.
Terror.
Oh my god. You know, typically, guys, if you're gonna tell me about a shortcut, you should probably tell me about it before I activate the boss cutscene. It usually helps. Wow. I don't know when I'm supposed to heal. I don't. Damage, even though I was running full speed. Interesting.
You got knocked the fuck out!
100%. You tell me. Yeah, what am I supposed to do? He fucking lands on me for an instant kill. Like, huh? Okay. Not much I can do about that. No, I'm not extending the stream, Captain Assault. I'm playing this more this week. I'm not extending the stream, so just deal with it.
Ah!
only does 90% damage. Fuck you. The Constable's Guard. DSP is really cool. I'm not ignoring a lot of your cheers. You're cheering a lot, and you're cheering so much that I'm trying. I can't even keep up with them. You know? It would make more sense for you to save up your cheers for a more meaningful cheer, like something really meaningful you want to say, and cheer with a bigger amount than doing all these small ones, because I can't keep up with what you're saying. You're just literally cheering so much. Every moment I'm playing the game, I can't keep looking back at your cheers. You know what I mean? Return to the Hunter's Dream, at least to get my fucking health and health potions back. Jeez. DSP is really cool. No worries, dude. You don't have to apologize. I just, like, being real, you know. You're cheering a lot, and you're saying to me, why aren't you reading all my cheers? It's because I'm trying to play a game. I can't constantly just re-cheer, or else what's the point of playing the game? See what I mean? So, no offense. I'm not offended. No need to apologize. Just like I said, maybe cheer a little bit less and make them bigger so that way they're more significant, you know? The Nightmare Church. It's cool, man. DSP is really cool. I appreciate it, dude. Any contributions you can make, I appreciate. Wow, my roll did not work out at all. Did not come out. Yeah, I don't know. I don't even think I want to waste healing right now. I didn't want to waste it. I know he gets the sword after a while. I was getting him, and then all of a sudden he just did an attack that I didn't even see because of the camera, and I'm dead. I don't even know what happened. I don't even know what happened. I don't even remember this pattern. Like, wait a minute. When I fought him the first time, I thought he had a sword. Right? He never did this attack pattern the first time I fought him. Am I right? So, maybe because I played a new game plus the first time around, he skips this first pattern and goes to the second? Because I don't remember this at all. I don't remember fighting him at all and him doing any of that shit. I remember him having the sword and fucking me up with it. Right? So I'm right. He never did the phase one the first time I played the game. Oh shit.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my god. Stop fucking lying!
I tried. Nothing happened. What? Where was I? Yeah, this is a dumb fight. I'm sorry, it is. I'm sure there's a pattern. I'm sure there's a pattern I'm supposed to learn, and it's going to take me a while. There's no way I'm going to beat it now, so that's it for today. You know, I'm sure there's some pattern or some weakness you saw. Sometimes I would stab him either in the face or the leg, and he was stunned. But I don't know. It just seems like he's too fast, and he has insane range. That's why he's such a pain in the ass to begin with. So. All right, well. The next thing is, the next time I play this game, I'll be focusing just on him to get past it. So there you go. All right.